If you're like me, you've been really excited by a lot of the announcements from Microsoft Ignite this week. Really super cool stuff. But one of the announcements that may have been eclipsed is the public preview of modernized business units in Microsoft Dataverse Security, or Matrix business units. People have been describing as being able to give a user a security role from a different business unit to their currently in. Well, Microsoft Dataverse Security really hasn't changed markedly that much in certainly many years. But this, when you start to look at it, it's actually quite a fundamental shift. So I thought I'd give you a bit of an insight in what's actually going on underneath this new preview feature. So here is the blog post announcing the public preview. If you don't check out the Power Apps blog on a regular basis, I highly recommend it because you get so much good stuff there. And if you look at the blog post, the most important part at the initial onset here is that users are no longer restricted to accessing or managing data in their own business unit. And also security roles from different business units can be assigned to the users regardless of the business unit that the user belongs to. Now, there's a diagram kind of showing some examples here. But what I thought I'd do is I'd kind of just switch over to some slides here, because there's probably two main points that people come up against when they're using business unit access. And this is probably, this is why it's such a big deal for me. This is why it's a big change, because business units and users have been linked together. Intrinsically, it's like a user can only be assigned to a single business unit. So if you can imagine a scenario here where you've got somebody who's in Department A and then somebody in Department B, if that person in Department B needs access to any records that are owned by the user in Department A, you might think, oh, well, that's fine. We'll just go and add that user to Department A's business unit and they'll be able to get access. Well, the fundamental challenge there is that users can only be a member of a single business unit. And that single fact has been kind of an uncomfortable truth over the years. And so there's been sort of many ways of getting around that. We as a community, we found ways to address this. And one of those might be where you would simply just share the records. So this is a kind of probably the most straightforward and easy for the user to do if they've got permission. So that user in Department A would just share the record with Department B, and then they give them the access they need. Challenges with that is that it's quite hard to maintain. It's great for a small number of records, but if you do it at any scale, sharing can start to cause actually performance problems as well. Another option would be to give access via an access team. And these access teams are sort of like special teams that are lightweight, in the sense that when you share a record with an access team, it doesn't go and create lots and lots of principal object access records for the users. It's just for the team. And then you put that user in that team, and that means they get access to that record. And you know, that's quite a... There's templates that you can define types of access, or you can do it programmatically, and it's quite a commonly used, and it's certainly an approach, and it certainly gets around some of those performance challenges, but it can get horrendously complicated and very hard to maintain, and so you have to sort of code around that. Another option is where you would simply have a team that is in Department A's business unit, and you give them a security role. That team would have a security role. And then you'd add the user from Department B to that team. So what they're doing is they're sort of getting a by proxy, they're getting access to Department A's records because they're a member of a team that's owned by Department A. So the security role then gives them access to those Department A's records. And you know, that works quite well. It's quite a common solution. And you can even say, you can even start to sort of have the records owned by those teams as well, which means you can then sort of have filters to say, okay, well, show me all the records where they're owned by teams that I'm in. And so, you know, that again, that's another common approach. And security in Dataverse can get really, really quite complicated. But this new functionality, what it does is it aims to simplify that particular use case. And so rather than doing some of those complicated Teams-based or sharing-based approaches, what you can do is you can simply say, right, okay, I'm going to give the user in Department B a security role from Department A. Interestingly, that it's always been under the covers there have been security roles linked to business units, but you couldn't actually give a security role in a business unit outside of the user's own business units. Now, of course, what that means is that then, because I have the security role in Department A, I get access to the records that are owned by users in Department A, just in the same way as if I was a member of Department A. So it's quite a big deal. So another scenario is moving users between business units. Because if you had two users in Department A and you wanted to move one of those users over to Department B, well, if they're the owner of those records, then actually what happens is they kind of take those records with them. Now, there is a functionality, there always was functionality to say, okay, when you move the business unit, that user across, you could also then go and reassign all the records that they own to another user. But it was quite hard to manage, right? Because especially if you've got a large number of records and a large number of users. So what was happening is that people would move between business units and suddenly those records that they own looked like they were belonging to the new business unit. And not only that, the users in the department that they came from no longer had access. That was sort of like a real kind of gotcha. Well, so as with this new functionality, what happens is that we can move the user to Department B and they can still maintain being the owner of record one. So they can still have access to that record because they're the owner. However, it breaks the link between the owner and the owning business unit, because before, the owning business unit of a record was always the same as either the user or the team that owned the record. That was like a kind of a universal truth. They were always the same. So, but now with this new functionality, the key to understanding what's going on here is that we've now got two distinct fields. We've got the owner of a record and we've got the owning business unit of a record. Now, of course, what that means is that when I move over to Department B, the records that I own, the owning business unit can remain being owned by Department A. So users in Department A will still have access to it. And indeed, because I'm still the owner, I can then still get access using a security role to that record. So it does open up quite a new set of opportunities in the way that you would previously have engineered this kind of functionality. So let's take a look at actually what this looks like inside Microsoft Dataverse. So I've got two test users here. I've got test user one and test user two. Test user one is in Department A and test user two is in Department B. So I've got two browser sessions open here. And so you can see here that my security roles are just giving business unit access. So this is a record that's been created by user one and it's owned by that user. And then we've got another record here, which is created by user one, but it's owned by an owner team. And so you can see that we've got Department A being the owning business unit for the owning user record, and we've got a separate field for the owning business unit for the team. Now, this is the key thing here, is that we've got two separate fields, because this is not actually a field on the record. It's actually a field that comes from the owner, right? So it's the business unit on the owner user or the business unit on the owner team. And so I've only got access to these two records in my own department. Now, if I go into my administration and go into the settings and the features, there's this new switch here. And what this allows me to do is record ownership across business units. Okay, so this is what it's doing, and it's a preview at this stage, right? So it says don't use in production because it's obviously prone to change, etc. But you know, at some point it's going to come out of preview, and I've turned this on. So if we go over into the users here, what I've done is I've created a new view, okay, which just includes a new field. So we're no longer getting the owning business unit from the team or the user. There is a normal Dataverse field in the same way as the owner, and it's set at the moment by default to the same department that of the owner. Okay, so if you go to this one here again, department B for the records created by test user 2 and department A for the records that are created by user 1. But if I go into the actual record, you can see that this owning business unit is editable. Okay, and this is the really key part here, is that we're breaking the link between the owning business unit and the owner of the record. So let's look at actually what it looks like. Let's say we have that first scenario where we wanted to give access of department B's records to the test user 1. And the way we do that is we come into our users. So here we go, test user 1, and we would go to manage security roles. And what this allows me to do is the same as it would do in any other scenario, select from all the different roles that I want to assign this user. But the most important thing here is that we can select which department, which business unit we want to give that security role from. So previously, we would only ever been able to give it from Department A because that was the way it was locked down. But now this opens up a whole new opportunity to say Department B. So I'm going to go and give it access to this secured access role, which gives us business unit level access to these records. So if I go back over into my test user 1 and I refresh my view, suddenly I've got access to all of Department B's records because I've got business unit access, level access in Department B through that security role. So that's pretty amazing stuff. Now, let's also look at the scenario where we wanted to move a user from one Department A over into Department B, but not actually jeopardize access for existing users, etc., to those records. And so there are a couple of these settings here in the org settings DB, and I'm just using the XRM toolbox org settings tool here. There's do not remove roles on change business unit, and also always move record to owner business unit. So these aren't, at the moment, there's no way of setting these other than through a tool like this. But what these mean is that they control what happens when I change the business unit of a user. So I've got it set to true for do not remove roles. So that means that if I move my user from business unit A, department A to B, it should not change the security roles. If you remember before, when you changed a user's business unit, bang, suddenly all their security roles were removed. Whereas now what we're saying is that it's going to retain all of those security roles. Also, this second one I've got set to false, which is always move record to owner business unit. And what that means is that previously, if you remember, because when we moved a record's ownership from one business unit to another business unit, intrinsically the owning business unit would move as well, because it was just a related field. Whereas now, because we've got a specific field on a record that says owning business unit, you can say, if I move my user, do we want to automatically update that owning business unit field or not? So I've got that set to false. So it will stay being owned by the previous business unit. Let's do that. Let's go move this user here. I'm going to say change business unit here. And so we can say, well, I'm going to change it to department B. Now, notice this little checkbox is grayed out because it's controlled by that org settings. Potentially, this will be at some point maybe ungrayed out. So I can actually select what I want to do. At the moment, you can only change it by that org settings DB control. So if I say okay, and then just give it a moment to make that change. Okay, so if we go back over to test user one and refresh, I can still see all the users, all the records from both department A and department B. Notice that the owning business unit of my the records that I own, test user one, I own this record and it is owned by department A. Even though I have actually changed my business unit, if I open up that user record and look at the business unit, you'll see that it's moved over to department B. So the business unit is department B. If I go to my old view, you can see for this record created in department A, the business unit is now department B. So in the old functionality, any users in department A would have lost access to this because it's moved over to department B. But as it is, they would still be able to access it. I can now still access my records in department A because I have that role in department A, because I've got a role in both department A and in department B. So what it means is that we've now got this separation between business units and the way in which records access is controlled by business units and the business units that users actually reside in. Also, that I could go into any of these records, and if I wanted to, I could even change the owning business unit. So when I'm creating a record, I could even say, well, I want to create it in a different business unit that I actually I'm a member of, as long as I've got append to rights on that business unit and append rights on the record that I'm creating. I could just select whichever business unit I wanted to. So this is actually kind of a fundamental shift in the way in which security is going to be managed going forwards with this kind of functionality. I don't think necessarily it's always going to mean that you won't need to use access teams or owner teams and things like that. But I think for some of the more basic scenarios where you're doing things like moving users around or wanting to give seconded access from one to a user because maybe they're temporarily working in another department, or maybe they work in multiple departments, it kind of breaks this link that we always had, this hard link between a user could only ever exist in one business unit, therefore business unit and child security rights were always limited in that way. Anyway, hopefully you've kind of got a little bit of insight. Highly recommend kind of just playing around with it, maybe enabling it on one of your sandboxes and trying out some of the scenarios that you've been using previously in your organization and see what this new feature can unlock for you. Anyway, until next time, take care. Cheers.